Hello students, in the last video we have discussed about the discovery of cell and the cells of onion peel. The cells of the onion peel will all look the same regardless of the size of the onion they came from. That means the cells of the small onion as well as the cells of the big onion all will look the same. These small structures called cells are the basic building units of the onion bulb. Cells are the basic building units of the onion bulb. All organisms which are present around us are made up of cells. The discovery of microorganisms and microscopic world took place after the invention of magnifying lenses. And by the help of magnifying lenses only, smaller organisms like unicellular organisms were observed. Unicellular organisms and multicellular organisms are two types of organisms based on number of cells present in them. Organisms which are made up of single cell. Organisms which are made up of single cell are called as unicellular organism. For example, amoeba, paramecium, bacteria, chlamydomonas. Amoeba, paramecium, bacteria, chlamydomonas, etc. are unicellular organisms which are made up of single cell. Multicellular organisms are made up of a number of cells, or organisms which are made up of many cells or number of cells are called as multicellular organisms. Example, plants, animals including human beings, fungi except yeast. Most of the fungi are multicellular organism except yeast. Yeast comes under fungi, but it is unicellular. Yeast is unicellular, but most of the fungi are multicellular. Every multicellular organism has come from a single cell called zygote. Every multicellular organism has come from a single cell that is called zygote. The fusion of male gamete called sperm with the female gamete called ovum give rise to single cell zygote. And the zygote contains both paternal and maternal chromosomes, means father's and mother's chromosome. Later, the zygote repeatedly undergoes cell division and gives rise to multicellular organism. That means all cells thus come from pre-existing cells. All cells thus come from pre-existing cells. In some organisms, we can observe different kinds of cells. In some organisms, we can observe different kinds of cells. For example, in human beings, we can observe different kinds of cells like smooth muscle cell, blood cells, nerve cells, fat cells, bone cells, sperm, egg, etc. All these cells are of different kinds. The shape and size of these cells varies. The shape of the ovum or egg is spherical. The shape of the fat cell is elliptical. The shape of the smooth muscle cell is spindle. The shape of the bone cell is stellate, whereas the sperm is knobbed thread. It's a thread-like structure having knob at one tip. That knob is nothing but sperm head. So like this, in human beings, we can observe the cells of different shape and different size. And in some organisms, like amoeba or single-celled organism, they have the capacity of changing their shape. Amoeba always change their shape. In human beings, the different types of cells, what we have discussed now, are having fixed shape. The shape of the smooth muscle cell, blood cell, nerve cell, fat cell, bone cell, etc. are fixed. That means their shape will not change. Each living cell has the capacity to perform certain basic functions, and that are the characteristic of all living forms. All cells present in an organism has the capacity to perform particular basic functions. In multicellular organism, there is a division of labor. In multicellular organism, like human beings, there is a division of labor. That means different functions are performed by different organ systems. In human beings or in higher organisms, many cells are present and group of cells forms tissues. Group of tissues forms organs. Group of organs forms organ systems. So in higher organisms, some functions are performed by tissues, some functions are performed by organs, and some other functions are performed by organ system. Organ system is nothing but group of organs. In human beings, well-developed digestive system is present. It plays a major role in the digestion of food. Well-developed respiratory system plays a major role in exchange of gases. Organ like heart is specialized to pump the blood. Well-developed circulatory system pumps the blood or transport the blood to different parts of the body. The blood carries oxygen to different parts of the body. Well-developed excretory system, which includes kidney, filters the blood. Excretory system removes the waste which are produced during metabolic activities present in the blood. In unicellular organism, there is no organ systems, or there is no tissues, organs. Only one cell is present in unicellular organism. Here, or in unicellular organism, different functions are performed by specific components which are present within these cells, called cell organelles. In unicellular organisms, different functions are performed by the cell organelles like mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi apparatus, lysosome, etc., which are present in the cell. Each kind of cell organelle performs a special function. Like mitochondria synthesize the energy, lysosome which clearing up the waste material or dead cells, endoplasmic reticulum which transport the substances within the cell or from one cell to another cell, etc. These cell organelles together constitute the basic unit called the cell. A cell is a tiny mass of protoplasm which is surrounded by a membrane and is capable of performing all functions of life. A cell is a tiny mass of protoplasm. Protoplasm means cytoplasm and nucleus. Cytoplasm and nucleus together forms protoplasm. A cell is a tiny mass of protoplasm which is surrounded by a cell membrane or plasma membrane and is capable of performing all functions of life. A cell has three parts such as plasma membrane, nucleus and cytoplasm. A cell has mainly three parts such as plasma membrane, nucleus and cytoplasm. In brief, let us discuss about the structure of plasma membrane. Plasma membrane is also called as cell membrane. It is the outermost covering in most of the organisms. But in plant cells, fungi and many bacteria, outer to the plasma membrane, cell wall is present. But in humans, human cell, cell wall is absent. Plasma membrane is also called as selectively permeable membrane because it allows the entry of certain substances. Plasma membrane is also called as selectively permeable membrane because it allows the passage, entry or exit of selected substances. Hence it is called selectively permeable. And plasma membrane is a living flexible membrane. It's a living flexible membrane. It is made up of a bilayer of lipid. Plasma membrane is made up of a bilayer of lipid, lipid bilayer. And plasma membrane contains two types of proteins, intrinsic protein and extrinsic protein. Intrinsic protein and extrinsic protein. And carbohydrates, small carbohydrates are attached to the surface of lipids and proteins. That means plasma membrane made up of bilayer of lipids, then intrinsic and extrinsic proteins and small carbohydrates which are attached to the outer surface of the lipids and proteins. Thank you.